This is now, I understand, the first animation program out of the Disney people.
Yes,
who,
it
of
is.
Course, the animation people.
Yes.
And what was the theory in bringing this out on the Amiga platform first?
We brought out on the Amiga because the Amiga has graphics capabilities that are very well suited to this particular type of display.
All right, show it to us. Let's see how this works.
I'm very happy to. Let's boot up here. Here's the animation studio. And what I'll do is I'll just create a very quick animation for our eyes here.
Okay. This is in real time. No magic.
Yeah.
Well,
and you're not an artist, right?
Yes. Anyone who knows what they're doing will know that this is not an artistic endeavor. But you can see that the animation studio allows me to see back through the paper.
Right.
Simulation of paper.
So we're seeing several cells at once, basically, is that
right? And it allows me to get very accurate control over what's happening, and I can see what's going on in the background, which allows me an incredible amount of control. And you can see here in just seconds, I've been able to create an animation before your eyes.
Very nice.
In addition to having an easy-to-use animation package, we also wanted to not just drop the user off there, we wanted to help them out by providing a variety of animations that they can actually learn from.
Animated clip art, in essence.
Yes. These are the fundamental lessons that animators are actually taught. And you can see I can see through this and study it. We provide several of these that cover all of the basics of animation. In addition, we've included animations from the morgue, films and shorts. And this is what a Disney animator was able to do with that very same notion, using quite a bit of exaggeration and just basic Disney magic.
Mm-hmm. Could we see something in color?
Yeah, absolutely. The program also fully supports color. And what I'll do is I'll take one of the included animations and color it in for you very quickly. Here's a bird demonstrating the basic notion of flight. And what I'll do...
And we're coloring each cell motion in this case.
Yes, I am. And there are only six cells.
So you're manually coloring each cell.
Yes.
And you haven't automated this process in here.
No.
Still, it goes pretty quick.
Yeah, it goes pretty fast. And what I'll do is I'll color in his body.
I assume this is mainly to give them greater control?
The reason that you color this way is because it's an emulation of the way it's done traditionally.
Uh-huh.
And as you can see, it's actually very fast.
Wow. That's great.
In addition to these animations, we've also included a completed animation. We set loose one of our Disney animators and said, what would you do with this package? And that's this animation here. It's included with the package.
And this was created using this software?
It was painted and superimposed on the backgrounds with the package.
Wow.
And we're very proud of it. Here you can see Donald is using a computer, and he's loading his animation. It's taking a little longer than he's expecting. And to his surprise, Mickey comes up instead of Donald, and he loses his temper, and he strikes a key.
It's just like work.
That's great.
Only from Disney.
And Tim, as you were saying before, this is really the advantage this machine has in doing this particular kind
Absolutely.
Of work.
Absolutely.
All right, gentlemen, thank you.
These spaceships are from a new American science fiction TV series called Babylon 5. What is very different about them is that they only exist inside the memory of an Amiga computer and are not models, which is how these sort of effects would usually be made on TV. The special effects supervisors plugged three Amiga computers together and used a new machine called a video toaster to create these stunning visuals. Director Steven Spielberg was so impressed by the video toaster that it's already being used in his new underwater adventure TV series, SeaQuest DSV, where the whole futuristic submarine exists only inside the computers. The video toaster works by first building a simple line diagram of the spaceship inside the computer. Then it puts on the rest of the picture, layer by layer. To build this space station for Babylon 5, the video toaster used over 200,000 polygons, which is the shape that the computer uses as the basic building blocks for creating the final picture. But the video toaster can also do many other jazzy graphics. Live video images can be integrated into the video toaster's memory, so you can mix computer graphics with real people like this. We'll be right back. The toaster also contains a 24-bit paint package containing over 16 million colors that can be painted onto existing pictures. This is a program for the toaster called Lightwave 3D, which creates highlights and shadows on objects, giving them a more three-dimensional feel as the viewer's eye moves around them. So what does a video toaster actually look like? Well, it's a video card that fits over the top of the motherboard on the Amiga computer and is accompanied by 45 discs containing some of the hottest rendering and video manipulation software there is. The brand new Toaster 4000 is available for not only the American and Japanese NTSC TV formats, but also the PAL system, which most of the rest of the world uses. So watch out at your local computer store later on this year if you want to create some stunning computer graphics with a video toaster of your very own.